Hello all, welcome, good evening. My name is Dr. Lakshmi Kilaru. I am a nutritionist and a food scientist working here for Apollo Life. As we all know, this week is the World Obesity Week. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about obesity. What exactly is obesity? What causes obesity? What are the various factors which lead to obesity? And are there any treatments with obesity? And how we at Apollo Life can help you achieve your targeted weight if in case you fall into obese category, or if you are not in a healthy weight range, or if you are in somewhere in between. So for all the reasons, right reasons, we at Apollo Life have a team of experts, of nutritionists, physiotherapists, behavioral therapists here to help you achieve your targeted weight. So let's start by talking a little bit about obesity. What is obesity? Obesity today in this world has become an epidemic. Why so? And what is it? So it's a condition in which the person's there's an accumulation of body fat in a person that leads to negative effects on their health. So is there any categorization of this obesity? Of course, yes. First of all, we can categorize this with the help of a BMI. BMI is the body mass index, which defines if you are in a healthy weight range or if you are normal or if you are obese, right? So what is the number for obesity? If your BMI falls in a range of 25 to 30, that categorizes you as an obese person. So is there any other categorization? Does genetics lead to obesity? Of course. When we are looking at genetics and obesity, scientists have found that there is a mutant gene called as MP4, which leads to obesity. If you have this gene, in case there is a mutation of this gene in our body, no matter what you do, you cannot lose proper amount of weight through normal techniques. So what exactly is happening when you have a mutation of this gene? There are two kinds of hormones which we have to understand lead to obesity. One is leptin and one is ghrelin. So what is leptin? Leptin, as the name indicates, comes from Greece. It means thin. That is, leptin is a thinning hormone. It helps you lose weight. The opposing hormone is ghrelin. So ghrelin is a hunger hormone. So when there is an imbalance in the leptin and ghrelin hormones, your satiety level is lesser and your hunger pangs increase. So that is where there is a genetic discrepancy between these two hormones, and it leads to obesity. So next, following it, what are the various factors that lead to obesity? First is the dietary pattern. As we all know, that eating bad food or eating wrong food leads to obesity. So that was in layman terms. Coming to the scientific terms, what kind of dietary patterns lead to obesity? Eating more of unprocessed foods, right, would cause less amount of obesity. So the opposing, if you're eating more processed foods, that is, if you are eating more sugary foods, more salty foods, and if you're eating more bakery products, all these lead to obesity. And also coming to your drinks, like your diet sodas, for example, your Coke or your Sprite, all these carbonated beverages also lead to obesity. And last but not the least, for adults, smoking as well as alcoholism also leads to obesity. Next category is exercise. So we all know that exercise improves your oxytocins and your serotonins, that is the happy hormones. Once your oxytocins and serotonins are released, it keeps your body stable and your hormones happy, that is, you have hormonal balance. In case you have a sedentary lifestyle and you are not exercising, then there is an imbalance in the hormones that lead to various other diseases, such as your thyroid imbalance, your PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease, where you have insulin sensitivity, and many other diseases such as fatty liver, etc. Next, coming to what kind of diseases do obesity lead to? Obesity leads to various kinds of non-communicable diseases, such as your diabetes, your thyroid, okay, fatty liver, etc. All these diseases, the main cause of all these diseases again is obesity. Next, coming to sleep, why do we need sleep at all? You need 6 to 8 hours of normal sleep. that is to reboot your system, that is to reboot all your organs. If there is less amount of sleep, then it leads to more amount of cortisol in the body. What is cortisol? Again, this connects to stress. So if you're more stressed, the body releases a hormone called as cortisol. In case you have more cortisol, that leads to more visceral fat. Again, it's a cycle where more visceral fat leads to metabolic syndrome diseases. Again, causing diabetes, causing cardiovascular heart diseases, fatty liver, etc. So we have spoken about what is obesity, what leads to obesity. Next, coming to treatment of obesity. In case you fall into obese category, what kind of help can you get and what are the ways that you can treat obesity? So we at Apollo Life have a team of physiotherapists. We have the best nutritionists and we also have the behavioral therapists. So when you walk into Apollo Life, we can measure your BMI, your body mass index, and define where you fall into. And we can also categorize your fat, free fat mass, your muscle, how much of water weight is there, how much of sodium retention is there. By calculating all these, our experts can help you reach your targeted weight loss. So welcome again, and if you have any questions regarding obesity or any other lifestyle disorders, what kind of food you need to take in, what kind of diet you need to take in to achieve your results, I am glad to help you today. So shoot your questions.
Sure. So like we said in the beginning, we have received so many questions, so we will pick few of them and try to answer. The first question is from Bubbly Kumar. So it is, how can I get weight loss and can you please suggest me the best diet for weight loss? And I have thyroid as well.
Well, Mr. Bubbly, if you're saying thyroid, I would have to know the details if you are hypothyroid or hypothyroid. So if you're saying you have to lose weight, so I'm considering it as hypothyroid, where you have less functioning of your thyroid hormone. So there are two things. First of all, we need to know your BMI and also give you the right amount of food according to your body mass index. So if you walk into Apollo Life Studio, we can help you. But then again, I can give you tips on losing weight for thyroid. So if you have thyroid levels, that if you have imbalance in thyroid levels, first of all, you need to get your test done. And when you get your test done, based on your thyroid levels, you need to take a replacement hormone therapy. You need to take it at the right time for the right kind of body weight. And also you need to follow a certain diet plan. In that diet plan, you need to include high metabolic foods, because in hypothyroid, you tend to have low metabolism. So to improve your body metabolism, you can take foods such as cinnamon water, ginger water, lemon water, etc. And you need to have more unprocessed carbohydrates. You need to have more whole grains such as your millets, your quinoa, and also you need to avoid some kind of vegetables which they say are goitrogenic foods. Goitrogenic foods include your vegetables such as your cabbage, your cauliflower, your broccoli, etc. So most people say that if you have thyroid, you need to avoid your goitrogenic foods. But then again, these goitrogenic foods have also are high in antioxidants, which are cancer fighting substances. So you need to eat these kind of vegetables also, but there's a form in which you can cook and remove the goitrogens. You need to steam or you need to boil them in warm water for about 5 minutes. So since goitrogens are water soluble, they leach into this warm water, and thereby you strain the water, and then you can stir fry it or you can cook it and you can have it. And also you need to exercise well, exercise at least 3 to 5 times a week for 30 to 40 minutes. And also you need to have less stress, and also improve your water intake, hydration levels, and also improve your sleep levels. So these are some of the tips that I can give you if you have high thyroid.
So next question is from Mr. Vijay. He says, ma'am, what kind of foods to take before workout and after workout?
Well, Mr. Vijay, there are a lot of foods that you can include. So having right amount of food pre-workout is necessary for basically to increase your exercise endurance. So pre-workout foods could be fruits like banana, like apple. You can also have a protein shake with your fruit, and also you can have some amount of almond milk mixed with your nuts, and also you can have homemade granola bars. You can have a mixture of your granola, your almonds, your cranberries. You can mix them up and bake them, and also you can have a high amount of proteins such as your egg, or you can have a toast with a little bit of peanut butter in them. And also it depends on how long do you have a time pre-workout. Like if you're having less than an hour, you need to eat foods that digest really well, and if you have more than 2 hours, you can include high fiber foods in them. So post-workout again you need to have foods which are high in protein. So I would say mostly go for egg whites. You can have a fistful of nuts, and you can always have a grilled chicken, 3 ounces of grilled chicken with some steamed vegetables, and also you can have some protein shakes for your muscle recovery.
Alright, so next question is from Tanmay Reddy. Hi, I would like to know diet to get weight gain. Though I eat more at regular timings, no improvement of weight.
Okay, Mr. Tanmay, here's what you need to understand. So if you need a real weight gain, you need to include more good proteinaceous foods. So when I say good protein foods, and you also need to include good fat foods. So also you need to calculate the amount of protein you need for your body. So if you're trying to gain weight, for a normal person, I would give 0.8 grams per kg of body weight to lose weight or gain the necessary weight. If you are looking at gaining weight and gaining muscle mass, you need to take about 1.2 grams of protein per body weight, for a body weight. So for example, you can include foods such as your egg whites. You can include, if you are a non-vegetarian, you can include egg whites, you can include keema, you can include your lean meat such as your chicken, grilled chicken, you can include grilled fish, and also you can include more of phytonutrients such as your legumes, your pulses and your nuts. So by improving your protein content and by improving your good fats, by good fats I mean you can take in your monounsaturated and your polyunsaturated fatty acids. Those include your sunflower seeds, your peanuts, and also your omega-3 fatty acids such as your flax seeds, and you can also include chia seeds. These are some amount of foods which will help you gain good amount of weight without gaining the fat amount.
Okay. Anamta Khan says, I have pigmentation. Can you please suggest some diet for me?
Okay. If you say you have pigmentation, the first thought that I would get is if you have an insulin sensitive disorder. If you have an insulin sensitive disorder, that means it would lead to PCOD. So I would advise you to first get a check with your gynecologist, get some blood work done, and get your insulin levels checked, serum insulin levels checked, and also get your check with a gynae and see where your HbA1c level lies, your fasting glucose and also your post-lunch glucose. So if you have a PCOD, then I would advise you to go ahead with some medication. With that way you can reduce your insulin sensitivity. Once your body normalizes your insulin and your glucose levels, the pigmentation would die down on itself.
Okay. Thank you. Next is Sumana Honey. So she says, what rice or roti? Which one is better?
So again, I would like to educate you, Sumana, a little bit about what are good carbs and what are bad carbs. So most people say, I want to eat a carb-free food. Is it good or is it bad? Of course, you need carbohydrates for your food, for your diet, because they are the immediate source of energy. So you cannot sustain well without on a zero-carb diet. So what are bad fats? When I say bad fats, and in layman terms, I would say anything which is white is bad. For example, your white rice, your white maida, your white bread, anything white sugar. So the ballpoint, anything white and it is a carbohydrate, do not eat it. And if it is brown, for example, whole grains, your brown rice, your millets, your quinoa, which is high in fiber. When there is more amount of fiber, there is more satiety. So when there's more satiety, you feel less hunger and thereby you gain lesser weight. So when I explain all this, you can pick up the answer whether it's white rice or your brown roti. So going for unprocessed foods.
Okay, so next is from Shreya. He says, omelet or boiled egg, which is better for protein needs of your body?
Well, Shreya, we all know the answer. Boiled egg is boiled only in water and there is no oil added to it. So of course, boiled egg has calories of about, I would say, 78 to 80. And when you fry the egg or when you add more oil to the egg, you are increasing the saturation levels. So I think the calorie content would increase up to 90 kilocalories. And also the saturated fat would increase if you're not using a good amount of oil. So always, I would say, boil your egg rather than eating fried. That is, if you're adding more oils to it.
Okay, we have one more question from, we don't know the name, Dr_27C. What is the correct diet for lose weight? Heavily protein, fats with low carbs, or only protein?
Well, doctor, we would like to assess you based on your BMI, and also we would like to do a body composition analysis on you. We have to see what content of muscle you have, what kind content of protein is there in your muscle, and how much amount of fat percentage do you have, and what is the water content in your body. So based on that, we are a nutritionist here at Apollo Life would recommend you the right kind of food. If you need a high fiber diet, or if you need a low carb diet, or if you need a high protein diet, based on your requirements.
Alright. So next question is from Miss Nilima. She says, my son is 8 years old. His weight is 40 kg. He eats rice 3 times a day. Please suggest him. Says if he doesn't listen to her much.
Well, Nilima, what? I mean, if your son is 8 years and he's already 40 kgs, I am seeing a condition of obesity in him. So I think you have to take the right kind of action at the right time, so he doesn't go into adolescence being obese, and he wouldn't develop any kind of diseases. So first off, you have to assess him, take him to a pediatrician and assess him, and see if there is any genetic mutation in him, or if it is the unhealthy food choices that you guys make. So if it is just rice 3 times a day, I would ask you to break it down to brown colored foods. Children usually do not like rice, so probably you can go in for a roll, for example a paneer roll, or you could make the roll or with a chapati. You could mix wheat, you can mix oats, and you can also put in some amount of flax seeds and make a flour out of it. With this flour you can make a roti, and you can stuff it with, for example, you can say protein like paneer, you can stuff it with chicken, you can also do sprouts roti, you know. And also you can, children like cutlets, so you can do keema cutlets, you can do soy cutlets. So you just have to innovate. And the second thing is activity. I would say you need to put him in a right kind of activity, be it football, basketball, or any other kind of sports, skating. So these days a sedentary lifestyle for children is leading to major kind of childhood obesity, which has become an epidemic in this world. So sedentary lifestyle, again, screens, as we all know. Most of the time, like during the 90s, there was a lot of playtime around, back in the houses and everywhere. But these days, it's more screen time. Like children are usually attached to the screens for like watching TVs or watching computers or laptops. So I would say, let children get some air, let them go out, get some oxygen, you know, burn some sweat. And that way, I think they would probably become healthier.
Next question is from Ms. Nisha More. Can you please suggest the diet for PCOS?
Well, Nisha, if you have a PCOS, that is a polycystic ovarian disease syndrome, it is basically a start of diabetes. That is, it is an insulin sensitive disorder. When I say insulin sensitivity, that means there is certain insulin receptors in your body. That is, there is insulin and there is glucose. For example, if the insulin has to enter into your glucose molecule, there is a gate in which gate it has to be opened and the insulin has to go in. So for insulin sensitive disorders, what happens is the gate is not opened. So the lock and key model is not well. That's why it causes insulin sensitivity. So during this insulin sensitivity disorder, you have to follow a right kind of diet. When I say a right kind of diet, you need to concentrate more on your carbohydrates. That is, you have to eat more of your brown carbohydrates. You need to eat wholesome carbohydrates like your brown rice, millets, quinoa. Focus on good fats such as monounsaturated fatty acids. Use more olive oil, use more walnuts, and use less of carbohydrates, more of protein, and less of bad fats. And also, your stress levels, keep your stress levels at bay. If your cortisols are high, your PCOD increases. So also get enough rest, enough water, and also your working conditions. So have a job which keeps you stress-free, and have a daytime job, and do not go in for night shifts. That's an advice for PCOD patients.
All right. So next is from Ms. Sagli Chaitanya Reddy. Hello, ma'am. Can you please suggest me normal diet because I am staying in hostel. I want to lose my weight.
Well, I get a lot of clients who say that I'm in hostel, ma'am. I cannot cook, so I cannot lose weight. I cannot become healthy. But well, they all say where there's a will, there's a way. So, for example, there are a lot of things that you could do. One thing is you can buy an induction stove or a microwave and start following some simple tips which I'm going to tell you. You can have oats for breakfast. All you have to do is get 120 ml of milk and have an oats porridge. In the oats porridge, you can mix your chia seeds a little bit. You can mix your almond powder. Getting almonds is not a big deal. And you can also add half an apple to that, and that's a wholesome breakfast. And mid-morning, you can take your fruits, whatever fruits you have, like you can have papaya, you can have watermelon. That need not be cooked. And for lunch, you can include more salads. And if you have a microwave or induction stove, you can cook your quinoa, you can cook your millets, and you can have curries of whatever is available in your hostel. And after your lunch, make it a point that you have a 15-minute walk or 15-minute activity where you digest a little bit of food. And after that, you can have a glass of buttermilk with, say, a little bit of flaxseed powder, which is easily available outside. Evenings, for snack, instead of going in for samosa or any unhealthy snack, you could go in for some sprout salad. Sprouts are easily available outside. You can just boil them or you can steam them. You can put a little bit of your lemon on them and put a little bit of onion and save and have it. Dinner, make sure you eat before 7 o'clock. Again, include your millets in your dinner. And post-dinner, you can have a walk. And this is an easy recipe to lose weight, even though you're staying in a hostel.
Okay, so we have just two more questions we'll be covering. Rest we can invite them to come to our place. Roshan says, is belly fat because of genetics? How significant is the role of genetics in weight gain or weight loss?
Well, as I told you earlier, yes, genetically obesity has a gene, mutant gene, but then again, belly fat can and cannot be genetic. It's basically because of the lifestyle in your family. Well, if most of the family is sedentary, or if most of the family has the similar eating habits. For example, if you have been rice eating families since two generations, three generations, but then again, you have a sedentary lifestyle. That is, you exercise less and eat more processed carbohydrates, eat more unsaturated fatty acids. That is, if you have more amount of snacks which are deep fried. So all these kind of lifestyle model changes can also lead to your belly fat. So if you have to reduce your amount of belly fat, there are some amount of exercises that you need to do. First of all, you need to start walking. Walking is a very good start of an exercise. Slowly you can jog, and you can increase your heart rate and do aerobic exercises or yoga, and follow a healthy lifestyle as in eating. Have an activity or have a number of steps. If you have a Fitbit watch, you can use it, and you can at least count your number of steps, starting from 5,000 steps to 10,000 steps in a day, and eat less amount of unprocessed food and go in for more raw vegetables, raw fruits, etc.